The second conceptual network model is TCP/IP model. In this lesson, we will learn the details of TCP/IP model. There are two TCP/IP models. One of them is four-layered old model, and the other is five-layered new model. Four-layered model has link, internet, transport, and application layers. Five-layered model has physical, data link, network, transport, and application layers. Here the difference is, in new model, physical and data link layers are different layers. Here we will focus on the new model and learn the details of the layers according to this layer. These layers are similar to the layers in OSI model. Physical layer is the layer which is responsible for bits transmission. Network cabling and connectors, radio signals are used in this layer. Bits are transferred over different medias with electrical signals and radio signals. This is similar to the layer 1 of OSI model. Old hubs are the devices used in this layer of TCP/IP model. Data link layer is the second layer of TCP/IP model. Again, it is similar to OSI data link layer. The main responsibility of data link layer is node-to-node delivery of the data. It provides an error-free transmission of the data. So, flow control, error detection, and CRC are used in this layer. Physical addresses, MACs, are also used in this layer. Data link layer adds a layer 2 header and a trailer to the data. By doing this, it creates frames: Ethernet, ATM, PPP, STP, VTP, LLDP are some protocols used in layer 2. The most popular layer 2 protocol is Ethernet. The third layer of TCP/IP model is network layer. The main duty of this layer is transmission of network packets from source to destination. This layer sets up logical connection between the nodes. Logical addressing, IP addresses, are used in network layer. It provides internet working. Routing is also done in this layer. Network layer adds a layer 3 header and creates packets. The devices used in this layer are routers, layer 3 switches, the devices that are IP capable, IPv4, IPv6, ICMP, IPsec, OSPF, and BGP are some of the network layer protocols. Transport layer is the fourth layer of TCP/IP model. It is responsible for end-to-end secure communication. Acknowledgements and retransmission is also used in this TCP/IP layer. Transmission control protocol TCP, user datagram protocol, and stream control transmission protocol SCTP are the common protocols used in transport layer. Transport layer uses a header also, and by doing this, it creates segments. The last layer of TCP/IP model is application layer. This layer combines the upper layers of OSI model. Let's remember, in OSI model, the latest three layers was session, presentation, and application layers. Here, only one layer do the similar jobs. This layer shields the upper layer applications from the complexities of data. It is a bridge between the network and the applications. HTTPS, SSH, NTP, FTP, DHCP, DNS are some common application layer protocols. We have finished our lesson. Now, let's test what we have learned. Question 1. How many layers are there in new TCP/IP model? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The answer is 5 layers. New TCP/IP model has 5 layers. Which TCP/IP layer combines upper layers of OSI model? Physical, data link, network, transport, or application? The answer is application. It combines session, presentation, and application layers. IP, ICMP, ARP works on layer ... of TCP/IP model. Physical, data link, network, transport, or application. It is internet layer. In which TCP/IP layer network cables and connectors are used? physical, data link, network, transport, or application. It is physical. And the last question, SSH, NTP, FTP are the protocols of ... layer of TCP/IP model. Physical, data link, network, transport, or application. It is application layer. Yes, it is over. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Good luck.